यूनिट 14 बायो मॉलिक्यूल्स। इट इज़ द हारमोनियस एंड सिंक्रोनस प्रोजेक्ट्स ऑफ केमिकल रिएक्शंस इन बॉडी विच लीड्स टू लाइफ। अ लिविंग सिस्टम ग्रोज, सस्टेन्स एंड रिप्रोड्यूसेस इटसेल्फ। द मोस्ट अमेजिंग थिंग अबाउट अ लिविंग सिस्टम इज दैट इट इज़ कंपोज्ड ऑफ नॉन लिविंग एटम्स एंड मॉलिक्यूल्स। द परस्यूट ऑफ नॉलेज ऑन व्हाट गोज ऑन बायोकेमिकली विदिन अ लिविंग सिस्टम फॉल्स इन द डोमेन ऑफ बायोकेमिस्ट्री। Living systems are made up of various complex biomolecules like carbohydrates, proteins, nucleic acid, lipids, etc. Proteins and carbohydrates are essential constituents of our food. These biomolecules interact with each other and constitute the molecular logic of life processes. In addition, some simple molecules like vitamins and mineral salts also play an important role in the function of organisms. Structure and functions of some of these biomolecules are discussed. Carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are primarily produced by plants and form a very large group of naturally occurring organic compounds. Some most common examples of carbohydrates are cane sugar, glucose, starch, etc. Most of them have a general formula CxH2O whole Y and were considered as hydrates of carbon, from where the name carbohydrate was derived. For example, the molecular formula of glucose C6H12O6 fits into this general formula, but all the compounds which fit into this formula may not be classified as carbohydrates. For example, acetic acid fits into this general formula, but is not a carbohydrate. Similarly, rhamnose is a carbohydrate, but does not fit in this definition. A large number of their reactions have shown that they contain specific functional groups. Chemically, the carbohydrates may be defined as optically acting polyhydroxyaldehydes or ketones, or the compounds which produce such units of hydrolysis. Some of the carbohydrates, which are sweet in taste, also called sugars. The most common sugar used in our homes is named as sucrose, whereas the sugar present in milk is known as lactose. Carbohydrates are also called saccharides. Carbohydrates are classified on the basis of their behavior on hydrolysis. They have broadly divided into following three groups. Monosaccharides, a carbohydrate that cannot be hydrolyzed further to give simpler unit of polyhydroxyaldehyde or ketone, is called monosaccharide. About 20 monosaccharides are known to occur in nature. Some common examples are glucose, fructose, ribose, etc. Oligosaccharides, carbohydrates that yield 2 to 10 monosaccharide units on hydrolysis are called oligosaccharides. They are further classified as disaccharides, trisaccharides, tetrasaccharides, etc. Depending upon the number of monosaccharides they provide on hydrolysis. Amongst these, the most common are disaccharides. The two monosaccharides units obtained on hydrolysis of a disaccharide may be same or different. For example, one molecule of sucrose on hydrolysis gives one molecule of glucose and one molecule of fructose, whereas maltose gives two molecules of only glucose. Polysaccharides, carbohydrates which yield a large number of monosaccharide units on hydrolysis are called polysaccharides. Most common examples are starch, cellulose, glucose, gums, etc. Polysaccharides are not sweet in taste, hence they are also called non-sugars. The carbohydrates may also be classified as either reducing or non-reducing sugars. Also, those carbohydrates which produce failing solution and tolerance reagent are referred to as reducing sugars. All monosaccharides, whether aldose or ketose, are reducing sugars. Monosaccharides. Monosaccharides are further classified on the basis of number of carbon atoms and the functional group present in them. If a monosaccharide contains an aldehyde group, it is known as aldose, and if contains a keto group, it is known as ketose. Number of carbon atoms constituting the monosaccharide is also introduced in the name, as it evident from the examples. Glucose. Glucose occurs freely in nature as well as in the combined form. It is present in sweet fruits and honey. Ripe grapes also contain glucose in large amounts. It is prepared as follows. From sucrose. If sucrose is boiled in dilute HCl or H2SO4 in alcoholic solution, glucose and fructose are obtained in equal amounts. C12H22O11 plus H2O gives H positive C6H12O6 plus C6H12O6, glucose and fructose. From starch, commercially glucose is obtained by hydrolysis of starch by boiling it with dilute H2SO4 at 393 Kelvin under pressure. C6H10O5 whole N plus NH2O gives NC6H12O6. Glucose is an aldohexose and is also known as dextrose. It is the monomer of the large carbohydrates, namely starch, cellulose. It is probably the most abundant organic compound on earth. It was assigned the structure given below on the basis of following evidences. Its molecular formula was found to be C6H12O6. On prolonged heating with HI, it forms an hexane, suggesting that six carbon atoms are linked in a straight chain. Glucose reacts with hydroxylamine to form an oxime and adds a molecule of hydrogen cyanide to give cyanohydrin. These reactions confirm the presence of carbonyl group. Glucose gets oxidized to 6 carbon carboxylic acid on reaction with a mild oxidizing agent like bromine water. This indicates that carbonyl group present is an aldehyde group. Acetylation of glucose with acetic anhydride gives glucose pentacetate, which confirms the presence of 5OH groups since it exists as a stable compound. 5OH groups should be attached to different carbon atoms. On oxidation with nitric acid, glucose as well as glucuronic acid both yield a dicarboxylic acid, saccharate acid. This indicates the presence of a primary alcoholic group in glucose. The exact spatial arrangement of different OH groups was given by Fischer after studying many properties. Its configuration is correctly represented as 1, so glucuronic acid is represented as 2 and saccharate acid is as 3. Glucose is correctly named as D plus glucose. D before the name of glucose represents the configuration, whereas plus represent dextrorotatory nature of the molecule. It should be remembered that D and L have no relation with the optical activity of the compound. They are also not related to the letter DL. The meaning DLL notation is as follows. The letters D or L before name of any compound indicate the relative configuration of a particular stereoisomer of a compound with respect to configuration of some other compound, configuration of which is known. In the case of carbohydrates, this refers to their relation with a particular isomer of glyceraldehyde. Glyceraldehyde contains one asymmetric carbon atom and exists in two enantiomeric forms as shown. Isomer of glyceraldehyde has deconfiguration. It means that when its structure formula is written on paper following specific conventions on which you will study in higher classes, the OH group lies on right hand side in the structure. All those compounds which are chemically correlated to D isomer of glyceraldehyde are said to have deconfiguration, whereas to which can be correlated to L isomer of glyceraldehyde are said to have L configuration. In L isomer, OH group is on left hand side, and you can see in the structure for assigning the configuration of monosaccharides, it is the lowest asymmetric carbon atom, which is compared as in glucose, which on the lowest asymmetric carbon is on the right side, which is comparable to glyceraldehyde. So glucose is assigned deconfiguration. Other asymmetric carbon atoms of glucose are not considered for this comparison. Also, the structure of glucose and glyceraldehyde is written in a way that most oxidized carbon is at the top. Cyclic structure of glucose. The structure of glucose explained most of its properties, but the following reactions and facts could not be explained by this structure. Despite having the aldehyde group, glucose does not give Schiff's test and it does not perform hydrogen sulfide addition product with NHSO3. The pentacetate of glucose does not react with hydroxylamine, indicating the presence of free CHO group. Glucose is found to exist in two different crystalline forms, which are named alpha and beta. The alpha form of glucose is obtained by crystallization from concentrated solution of glucose at 303 Kelvin, while beta form is obtained by crystallization from hot and saturated aqueous solution at 371 Kelvin. This behavior could not be explained by open chain reaction. Structure for glucose. It was proposed that one of the OH group may add to the CHO group and form a cyclic hemiacetal structure. It was found that glucose forms a six-membered ring in which OH at C5 is involved in ring formation. This explains the absence of CHO group and also existence of glucose in two forms as shown below. These two cyclic forms exist in equilibrium with open chain reaction. The two cyclic hemiacetal group forms of glucose differ only in configuration of the hydroxyl group at C1 called enolamic carbon. The aldehyde carbon before cyclization. Such isomers, that is alpha form and beta form, are called enomers. A six-membered cyclic structure of glucose is called pyranose structure. In analogy with pyrene, pyrene is a cyclic organic compound with an oxygen atom and 5 carbon atoms in the ring. The cyclic structure of glucose is more currently represented by Haber structure as given below.
Fructose is an important key to hexose. It is obtained along with glucose by the hydrolysis of disaccharide sucrose. It is a natural monosaccharide found in fruits, honey, and vegetables. In its form, it is used as a sweetener. It is also important key to hexose. Structure of fructose. Fructose also have molecular formula C6H12O6, and on the basis of its reaction, it was found to contain a ketonic functional group at carbon number 2 and 6 carbons in straight chain, as in case of glucose. It belongs to D series and is a levo rotatory compound. It is approximately written as D- fructose. Its open chain structure is as shown. It also exists in two cyclic forms, which are obtained by addition of OH at C5 to the CO group. The ring thus formed is a 5-membered ring and is named as furanose with analogy to the compound furan. Furan is a 5-membered cyclic compound with 1 oxygen and 4 carbon atoms. The cyclic structure of two enomers of fructose are represented by Haber structures as given. Disaccharides. We have already read that disaccharides on hydrolysis with dilute acids or enzymes yield two molecules of either the same or different monosaccharides. The two monosaccharides are joined together by an oxide linkage formed by the loss of a water molecule. Such a linkage between two monosaccharide units through oxygen atom is called glycosidic linkage. In disaccharides, if the reducing group of monosaccharides, aldehydic or ketonic groups, are bonded, these are non-reducing sugars, example sucrose. On the other hand, sugars in which these functional groups are free are called reducing sugars, for example maltose and lactose. Sucrose, one of the common disaccharide, is sucrose, which on hydrolysis gives equivalent mixture of D positive glucose and D negative fructose. These two monosaccharides are held together by a glycosidic linkage between C1 of alpha D glucose and C2 of beta D fructose. Since the reducing groups of glucose and fructose are involved in glycosidic bond formation, sucrose is known as a non-reducing sugar. Sucrose is a dextrorotatory, but after hydrolysis gives dextrorotatory glucose and levorotatory fructose. Since the levorotation of fructose is more than dextrorotation of glucose, a mixture of levorotatory. The hydrolysis of sucrose brings about a change in the sign of rotation from dextro to levo, and the product is named as invert sugar. Maltose, another disaccharide, maltose is composed of 2 alpha D glucose units in C1 of glucose 1, is linked to C4 of another glucose unit 2. The free aldehyde group can be produced at C1 of second glucose in solution, and it shows reducing properties, so it is a reducing sugar. Lactose, it is more commonly known as milk sugar. Since this saccharide is found in milk, it is composed of beta D galactose and beta D glucose. The linkage is between C1 of galactose and C4 of glucose.
3-aldehyde group may be produced as C1 of glucose unit.
Hence, it is a reducing sugar. Polysaccharides. Polysaccharides contain number of monosaccharide units joined together by glycosidic linkages. These are most commonly encountered carbohydrates in nature. They mainly act as the food storage or structural materials. Starch is the main storage polysaccharide of plants. It is the most important dietary source for human beings. High content of starch is found in cereals, roots, tubers, and some vegetables. It is a polymer of alpha glucose and consists of two components, amylose and amyloseptin. Amylose is a water soluble component which constitutes about 15-20% of starch. Chemically, amylose is a long unbranched chain with 200-1000 alpha D glucose units held under by C1 to C4 glycosidic linkage. Amylopectin is an insoluble in water and constitutes about 80-85% of starch. It is a branch chain polymer of alpha D glucose units in which chain is formed by C1 to C4 glycosidic linkage, whereas branching occurs by C1 to C6 glycosidic linkage. Cellulose occurs exclusively in plants and it is the most abundant organic substance in plant kingdom. It is a predominant constituent of cell wall of plant cells. Cellulose is a straight chain polysaccharide composed of only beta D glucose units which are joined by glycosidic linkage between C1 of one glucose unit and C4 of the next glucose unit. Glycogen. The carbohydrates are stored in animal body as glycogen. It is known as animal starch because its structure is similar to amylopectin and is rather more highly branched. It is present in liver, muscles and brain. When the body needs glucose, enzymes break the glycogen down to glucose. Glycogen is also found in yeast and fungi. Importance of carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are essential for life in both plants and animals. They form a major portion of our body. Honey has been used for a long time as an instant source of energy by vast in Ayurvedic system of medicine. Carbohydrates are used as storage molecules as starch in plants and glycogen in animals. Cell wall of bacteria and plants is made up of cellulose. We build furniture etc. from cellulose in the form of wood and clothe ourselves with cellulose in the form of cotton fiber. They provide raw materials for many important industries like textiles, paper, lacquers, and breweries. 2-aldopentose via D-ribose and 2-deoxy-D-ribose are present in nucleic acid. Carbohydrates are found in biosystem in combination with many proteins and lipids. Proteins. Proteins are the most abundant biomolecules of the living system. Key sources of proteins are milk, cheese, pulses, peanuts, fish, meat, etc. They occur in every part of the body and form the fundamental basis of structure and functions of life. They are also required for growth of and maintenance of body. The word protein is derived from Greek word proteos, which means primary or prime importance. All proteins or polymers are alpha amino acid. Amino acids contain amino, NH2 and carboxyl COOH functional group. Depending upon the relative position of amino group with respect to carboxyl group, the amino acids can be classified as alpha, beta, gamma, delta and so on. Only alpha amino acids are obtained on hydrolysis of proteins. They may contain other functional group also. All alpha amino acids have trivial names, which usually reflect the property of the compound or its source. Glycine is also named since it has sweet taste, and tyrosine was first obtained from cheese. Amino acids are generally represented by a 3 Greek letter symbol. Sometimes one letter symbol is also used. Structures for some of the commonly occurring amino acids, along with their 3 letter and 1 letter symbols, are given. Classification of amino acids. Amino acids are classified as acidic, basic, or neutral depending upon the relative number of amino and carboxyl groups in their molecule. Equal number of amino and carboxyl group makes it neutral. More number of amino than carboxyl group makes it basic, and more amino acids which can synthesize in the body
are known as essential amino acids. If the carboxyl groups are compared to amino groups, if they are more, it makes it acidic. On the other hand, those who cannot be synthesized in the body and must be obtained through diet are known as essential amino acids. Amino acids are usually colorless, crystalline solids. These are water-soluble, high-melting solids and behave like salts rather than simple amines or carboxylic acids. This behavior is due to the presence of both acidic and basic groups in the same molecule. In an aqueous solution, the carboxyl group can lose a proton and amino group can accept a proton, giving rise to a dipolar ion known as deuterion. This is neutral but contains both positive and negative charges. In deuterionic form, amino acids show amphoteric behavior as they react both with acids and bases. Except glycine, all other naturally occurring alpha amino acids are optically active since the alpha carbon atom is asymmetric. These exist both in D and L forms. Most naturally occurring amino acids have L configuration. L amino acids are represented by writing NH2 group on left hand side. Structure of proteins. You have already read that proteins are of the polymers of alpha amino acids and they are connected to each other by peptide bond or peptide linkage. Chemically, peptide linkage is an amide formed between COOH group and NH2 group. The reaction between two molecules of similar or different amino acids proceeds through the combination of amino group of one molecule with the carboxyl group of the other. This results in the elimination of a water molecule and formation of peptide bond. The product
of the reaction is called dipeptide because it is made up of two amino acids. For example, when carboxyl group of glycine combined with the amino group of alanine, you get dipeptide glycylalanine. If a third amino acid combines to a dipeptide, the product is called tripeptide. A tripeptide contains three amino acids linked by two peptide linkages. Similarly, when four, five, or six amino acids are linked, the respective products are known as tetrapeptide, pentapeptide, and hexapeptide, respectively. When the numbers of amino acids is more than 10, then the product are called polypeptides. A polypeptide with more than 100 amino acids reduced having molecular mass higher than 10,000 U is called a protein. However, the distinction between a polypeptide and a protein is not very sharp. Polypeptides with fewer amino acids are likely to be called protein if they are ordinary, have a well-defined conformation of a protein such as insulin, which contains 51 amino acids. Proteins can be classified into two types on the basis of their molecular shape. Fibrous proteins, when the polypeptide chains run parallel and are held together by hydrogen disulfide bonds, then fiber-like structure is formed. Such proteins are generally insoluble in water. Some common examples are keratin and myosin, etc. Globular proteins. This structure results when the chains of polypeptides coil around to give a spherical shape. These are usually soluble in water. Insulin and albumins are the common example of globular proteins. Structure and shape of proteins can be studied at four different levels: primary, secondary, tertiary, and quaternary, each level being more complex than the previous one. Primary structure of proteins. Proteins may have one or more polypeptide chains. Each polypeptide in a protein has amino acids linked with each other in a specific sequence, and it is this sequence of amino acids that is said to be the primary structure of that protein. Any change in the primary structure, that is the sequence of amino acids, creates different protein. Secondary structure of proteins. The secondary structure of protein refers to the shape in which a long polypeptide chain can exist. They are found to exist in two different types of structures, with alpha helix and beta pleated sheet structure. These structures arise due to the regular folding of the backbone of the polypeptide chain due to hydrogen bonding, CO and NH group of the peptide bond. Alpha helix is one of the most common ways in which a polypeptide chain forms all possible hydrogen bonds by twisting into a right-handed screw with the NH group of each amino acid residue hydrogens bonded to the CO of an adjacent turn of the helix. In beta pleated sheet structure, all peptide chains are stretched out to nearly maximum extension and then intermolecular hydrogen bonds laid side by side, which are held together. The structure resembles the pleated folds of drapery and therefore is known as beta pleated sheet. Tertiary structure of proteins. The tertiary structure of proteins represents overall folding of the polypeptide chains, that is further folding of the secondary structure. It gives rise to two major molecular shapes, viz. Fibrous and globular. The main forces which stabilize the 2 degree and 3 degree structures of proteins are hydrogen bonds, disulfide linkages, Wander Waals, and electrostatic forces of attraction. Quaternary structure of proteins. Some of the proteins are composed of two or more polypeptide chains, referred to as subunits. The special arrangements of these subunits with respect to each other is known as quaternary structure. A diagrammatic representation of all these four structures is given in figure, which a round color ball represent amino acid. Denaturation of proteins. Proteins found in biological system with a unique 3D structure and biological activity is called native protein. When a protein in its native form is subject to physical change like change in temperature or chemical change like change in pH,
The hyaline bonds are disturbed. Due to this, globules and folded helix get uncoiled and protein loses its biological activity. This is called denaturation of protein. During denaturation, secondary and tertiary structures are destroyed, but primary structure remains intact. The coagulation of egg white on boiling is a common example of denaturation. Another example of curdling of milk, which is caused due to formation of lactic acid by bacteria present in milk. Enzymes. Life is possible due to coordination of various chemical reactions in living organisms. An example is the digestion of food, absorption of appropriate molecules, and ultimately production of energy. This process involves a sequence of reactions, and all these reactions occur in the body under very mild conditions. This occurs with the help of certain biocatalysts called enzymes. Almost all of the enzymes are globular proteins. Enzymes are very specific for a particular reaction and for a particular substrate. They are generally named after the compound or the class of compounds upon which they work. For example, enzyme that catalyzes hydrolysis of maltose into glucose is known as maltase. Sometimes enzymes are also named after the reaction where they are used. For example, the enzymes which catalyze the oxidation of one substrate with a simultaneous reduction of another substrate are named as oxidoreductase enzymes. The ending of name of an enzyme is. Mechanism of enzyme action. Enzymes are needed only in small quantities for the progress of a reaction, similar to the action of chemical catalyst. Enzymes are said to reduce the magnitude of activation energy. For example, the activation energy of hydrolysis of sucrose is 6.22 kilojoule inverse, while the activation energy is only 2.15 when hydrolyzed by the mixture by the enzyme sucrose. Mechanism for the enzyme action has been discussed. It has been observed that certain organic compounds are required in small amounts in our diet, but their deficiency causes specific diseases. These compounds are called vitamins. Most of the vitamins cannot be synthesized in our body, but plants can synthesize almost all of them. So they are considered essential food factors. However, the bacteria of the gut can produce some of the vitamins required by us. All the vitamins are generally available in our diet. Different vitamins belong into various chemical classes, and it is difficult to define them on the basis of structure. They are generally regarded as the organic compounds required in the diet in small amounts to perform specific biological functions for normal maintenance of optimum growth and health of the organism. Vitamins are designated by alphabets A, B, C, D, E, etc. Some of them are further named as subgroups. B1, B2, B6, B12, etc. Excess of vitamins is also harmful, and vitamin pills should not be taken without the advice of doctor. The term vitamin was coined from the word vital plus amine, since the earlier identified compounds had amino groups. Later work shows that most of them did not contain amino group, so the letter E was dropped and the term vitamin is used these days. Classification of vitamins. Vitamins are classified into two groups depending upon their solubility in water or fat. Fat soluble vitamins. Vitamins which are soluble in fat and oils are called fat, but insoluble in water are kept in this group. These are vitamin A, D, E, and K. They are stored in liver and adipose tissues. Water soluble vitamins. B group vitamins and vitamin C are soluble in water, so they group together. Water soluble vitamins must be supplied regularly in diet because they are readily excreted in urine and cannot be stored except vitamin B12 in our body. Some important vitamins, their sources and diseases are caused by deficiency are listed below. Nucleic acids. Every generation of each and every species resembles its ancestors in many ways. How are these characteristics transmitted from one generation to the next?
It has been observed that nucleus of a living cell is responsible for this transmission of inherent characters, also called heredity. The particles in nucleus of the cell responsible for heredity are called chromosomes, which are made up of proteins and another type of biomolecules called nucleic acids. These are mainly two types, deoxyribonucleic acid and ribonucleic acid. Since nucleic acids are long chain of polymers of nucleotides, so they are also called polynucleotides. Chemical composition of nucleic acid. Complete hydrolysis of DNA or RNA yields a pentose sugar, phosphoric acid and nitrogen containing heterocyclic compounds called bases. In DNA molecules, the sugar moiety is beta 2 deoxyribose, whereas in RNA molecules beta D ribose. DNA contains four bases via adenine, guanine, cytosine and thymine. RNA also contains four bases. The first three bases are same as in DNA, but the fourth is uracil. Structure of nucleic acids. A unit formed by the attachment of a base to one disposition of sugar is known as nucleoside. In nucleosides, the sugar carbons are numbered as 1-2-3-. In order to distinguish these from the bases, a nucleoside is linked to phosphoric acid at 5' position of sugar moiety, we get a nucleotide. Nucleotides are joined together by phosphodiester. Linkage between 5' and 3' carbon atoms of the pentose sugar. The formation of a typical dinucleotide is shown. A simplified version of nucleic acid is as shown below. Information regarding the sequence of nucleotides in the chain of a nucleic acid is called its primary structure. Nucleic acids have secondary structure also. James Watson and Francis Crick gave a double strand helix structure for DNA. Two nucleic acid chains are wound about each other and held together by hydrogen bonds between pair of bases. The two strands are formed between specific pair of bases. Adenine forms hydrogen bonds with thymine, whereas cytosine forms hydrogen bonds with guanine. In structure of RNA, single-stranded helix is represented, which sometimes folds back on itself. RNA molecules are of three types and they form different functions. They are named as messenger RNA, ribosomal RNA, and transfer RNA. Biological functions of nucleic acid. DNA is the chemical basis of heredity and may be regarded as the reserve of genetic information. DNA is exclusively responsible for maintaining the identity of different species of organisms. For over millions of years, a DNA molecule is capable of self-replication during cell division, and identical DNA strands are transferred to daughter cells. Another important function of nucleic acid is protein synthesis in the cell. Actually, the proteins are synthesized by various RNA molecules in the cell, but the message for the synthesis of a particular protein is present in DNA. Hormones. Hormones are molecules that act as intercellular messengers. These are produced by endocrine glands in the body and poured directly into the bloodstream, which transport them to the site of action. In terms of chemical nature, some of these are steroids, example estrogens and androgens. Some are polypeptides, for example insulin and endorphins, and some are amino acid derivatives such as epinephrine and norepinephrine. Hormones have several functions in the body. They help to maintain the balance of biological activities in the bodies. The role of insulin in keeping the blood glucose level within the narrow limit is an example of this function. Insulin is released in response to the rapid rise in blood glucose level. On the other hand, hormone glucagon tends to increase the glucose level in the blood. The two hormones together regulate the glucose level in the blood, epinephrine and norepinephrine.
mediates responses to external stimuli. Growth hormones and sex hormones play a role in growth and development. Thyroxine, produced in the thyroid glands, is an iodine derivative of amino acid tyrosine. Abnormally low level of thyroxine leads to hypothyroidism, which is characterized by lethargyness and obesity. Increased level of thyroxine causes hyperthyroidism. Low level of iodine in the diet may lead to hyperthyroidism and enlargement of the thyroid gland. This condition is largely controlled by adding sodium iodide in the commercial table salt. Steroid hormones are produced by adrenal cortex and gonads. Hormones released by the adrenal cortex play a very important role in function of the body. For example, glucocorticoids control the carbohydrate metabolism, modulate mineral corticoids control the level of excretion of water and salt by the kidney. If adrenal cortex does not function properly, then one of the results may be Addison's disease, characterized by hypoglycemia, weakness, and increased susceptibility to stress. This disease is fatal unless it is treated, further responsible for development of secondary sex characters. Testosterone is the major sex hormone produced in males and is responsible for development of secondary male characteristics, deep voice, facial hair, general physical constitution, and estradiol is the main female sex hormone. It is the responsible for development of secondary female characteristics and participates in the controls of menstrual cycle. Progesterone is responsible for preparing the uterus for implantation of fertilized egg. Summary: carbohydrates are optically active polyhydroxyaldehydes or ketones or molecules which provide units of hydrolysis. These are broadly classified into three groups: monosaccharide, disaccharide, polysaccharide. Glucose is the most important source of energy for mammals. It is obtained by the digestion of starch. Monosaccharides are held together by glycosidic linkages to form disaccharides or polysaccharides. Proteins are the polymers of about 20 different alpha amino acids, which are linked by peptide bonds. 10 amino acids are called essential amino acids because they cannot be synthesized by our body and must be provided through diet. Proteins contain only alpha amino acids are called simple proteins. The secondary or tertiary are able to perform their function. This is called denaturation of proteins. The secondary or tertiary structure of protein get disturbed on change of pH of temperature, and they are not able to perform their functions. It's called denaturation of proteins. Enzymes are biocatalysts. It's speed up the reaction in biosystems. These are very specific and selective in their action, and chemically all enzymes are proteins. Vitamins are necessary food factors required in the diet. These are classified as fat soluble and water soluble. Deficiency of vitamins leads to many diseases. Nucleic acids are the polymers of nucleotides,
which in turn consists of base, a pentose sugar and phosphate moiety. Nucleic acids are responsible for transfer of character from parents to offspring. There are two types of nucleic acid, DNA and RNA. DRNA contains 5 carbon sugar called 2-deoxyribose, whereas RNA contains ribose. Both DNA and RNA contain adenine, guanine and cytosine. The fourth base is thymine in DNA and uracil in RNA. The structure of DNA is double strand, whereas RNA is single strand molecule. DNA is the chemical basis of heredity and have the coded message for proteins to be synthesized in the cell. There are three types of RNA, mRNA, rRNA, tRNA, which usually carry out the protein synthesis in the cell.